was always president of Stax. I was executive vice president. Jim Stewart was president of Stax. Over half a century ago, Jim Stewart founded and began a recorded music pursuit, which became the globally recognized and respected rare and authentic recorded soul music art form called Stax Records. Jim Stewart, S-T, S-T-L-A-X, Stax. Jim Stewart's sister, Estelle Axton, mortgaged her home to help finance Jim in expanding from a car garage studio, enabling him to locate his recorded music artist platform here in the heart and soul of Memphis's Black community. Soulsville, USA. The identifying nature of Stax Records is still alive and successfully functioning today. It is intangible. It will not die. You cannot destroy it. Why? It lives in the hearts, minds, and souls of the people. The identifying nature of Stax Records is still alive and successfully functioning, and it will continue to function. Good morning. You saw it here. Good morning. Good morning. It's a beautiful morning. How beautiful it is to see you all here to help celebrate 20 years of the Stax Music Academy. 20 years. Today, and you saw some of it, reminds me of a day I spent here some 6 years ago when I first really, really experienced the Stax Music Academy up close and personal. It was an important performance down the hallway here in the band suite, actually put together at the last minute because a lot of Stax Music appreciators and artists and I were gathered here for a festival that had to be postponed because of inclement weather. We all took our seats in the room to hear what we thought was going to be a song or two by some cute young audience, students rather, of the academy. What happened turned into both a tent revival of sorts and baptism by fire on our hearts. That's what happened that day. And as the full-fledged all-out concert began to unfold in front of our eyes, I kept thinking to myself, "Lord, you're not going to do that. You can't trap that." No, they didn't just do that, but they did. They did. These confident, talented young musicians came together and performed songs, and they did not cover them. It was like a powerhouse Broadway Stax musical. They didn't cover the songs. They gave their own unique interpretations of the songs. Authenticity. In that instant, I knew I would never be the same person again. I realized that for many years after the destruction of Stax Records, I had been carrying around a lot of compartmentalized pain, of which I wasn't even really aware of. I suppose a part of me always wondered if what we did at Stax Records would be of lasting importance. I knew that day that I would never have to worry about that again. I didn't have to give it another thought. It would live on. Those of you who know me well also know that my music life empowerment through music. And I would be remiss today if I didn't congratulate the Stax Music Academy for its successes in this arena. Young people from this school are out there making it, working in digital music distribution, working as performing and recording artists, as producers and engineers, touring all over the world, writing for the likes of Rihanna, Kanye West, and Paul McCartney, sharing festival stages with the likes of William Bell and Megan Thee Stallion. Again, that makes me feel a kind of peace that's hard to describe. So, Stax Music Academy, as you enter the 20th year, keep fighting a good fight and making those of us who helped build Stax Record some of the proudest people in the world. We love you for that. We love you for that. And God bless you. So be it.